Hello students, welcome back to the next session on DBMS. In this session, let us talk about data independence. Now, what is this data independence? That means that you access data. Data independence means accessing of data without disturbing or interrupting. Without disturbing the other related data, in the database. Okay, this is what you mean by data independence. Accessing of data without disturbing the other related data in the database. It is similar to when you want to call your friend out of a classroom or out of his house. You are calling only him. But you are not disturbing any other students of that class or of that house. That is what you mean by your data independence. But the data independence is possible only if the database system is multi-layered. If it is not multi-layered, then it is difficult to have data independence. Here you have different levels of data independence. The database, that is your internal database, conceptual database, and external database or external level. We'll go to this further. Before that, when you are saying independence, there are two types of independence, data independence. That is your logical data independence and physical data independence. Okay, now what is this logical data independence? Logical data independence means it is the data that is present in the database. It stores the information. Data is stored in the database, right? How are you going to manage it inside? How are you going to store the data? What are the conditions that you are going to apply in all that data? So it is a kind of a mechanism that is used on the actual data, on how the actual data is stored in the disk. How are you going to make any changes? What type of changes are you going to make? If you change that, what happens? All these comes under your logical data. In the same way, your physical data, so this is about your data in the database. Okay, whatever happens, happens on the data. In physical database, what we are talking about is, it is the way or rights to change the physical data. Where are you going to store? You are talking about the storage system in this. We are not talking about the data, but you are talking about the storage system in this. So where are you going to store? How many bits are required for this? How can you change the data without affecting the logical data? All these things are looked after by your physical data. So these are the two types of data independence: logical data independence and physical data independence. Now, when we are saying independence, it's also nothing but your abstraction, right? We are saying in data independence means the way you are going to get the information from the database without affecting the other database. So others should not know what is happening, right? That is what you mean by independence. The same thing is similar to, this is similar to your abstraction. What do you mean by abstraction? Abstraction means where you are going to know only what you want to know. The hidden some of the details which is not necessary for you are hidden, right? That is what you mean by your abstraction. In the same way, here also you have data abstraction. So there are different levels of data abstraction. So which are those levels? We have told already that the internal level, which are the internal level, the conceptual level, and external levels of database. So this is what your different levels of database are. So in this, you have the end user, and this is your external level. And you have your conceptual level. and physical level, that is got from your database. Okay, now we'll go one by one. Again, this is an important question. Explain about the different databases. So the first thing you have is your physical, or physical level is also known as your internal level. Physical level or internal level. Now what is this? It physical level is the internal level, and it is a physical storage of a database. This is the physical storage of database. So this will describe how are you going to store the data. It tells you how data is stored internally inside your database. How is it stored? It also describes the data structures that is used. It also describes your data structures that you are going to make use of in your database. That is your physical level or internal level. Then the next level is your conceptual level, or it is also known as your logical level. Conceptual level or logical level. This represents to you the complete content of the database. It gives you the complete content of the database. That is the records that you have in the database. What is the relationships among these records? All these are given by this logical level. So the global level of the database comes in the middle tier. That's it, is in between, in the middle part. And the conceptual level, it also has the logical structure of the entire database. Here you have the physical structure in physical level. Here you have the logical structure in the entire of the entire level. And the next part is your external level, or we also call it as your view level. That is, this is what the end users, this is what the end users will see. So a database will have one internal scheme and conceptual scheme, whereas it may have more than one external scheme as per the requirements of the user. Internal level is maybe single, the logical level may be single, but the external levels or the view levels may be more than one. This is what you mean by the different levels of database. Now the next part is the types of users. Now based on this levels, you'll have different types of users also. So who are those users? There are different types of users for the database in an organization. So each of them will have their own requirements. Everyone's requirements will not be the same. When you go for a shop to buy something or address also, some may like different types, different quality of the dresses, different sizes, different colors. It is their own personality, right? So each and every user will have their own requirements. In the same way, here also, each and every user will have their own requirements according to the contents of the database. So among these users, whoever is using this database, a few of them may be in the top level, some may be in the middle level, some may be the low level. So which are the different types of database users that you have? So this again is an important 3-mark question for you. The first user is your database administrator. Database administrator, we call it as DBA, as I said earlier. So this is the person, database administrator is the person who is going to create, alter and use the database. This is a person who is going to create the database. You can make changes to the database and also uses the database. And this administrator will provide the blueprint, how it should be, how should the database be. Everything of the database, the blueprint of the database is given by the administrator, and he or she has the overall control of the database. only the administrator can give the permission for the other users if they want to use any data or access any data. And next is your database designer. Database designer. Now, this is the person who, according to the blueprint that is given by the database administrator, will design the database scheme by applying the rules and regulations and the specifications of the database. Now, database designer is the person that is, what does he do? He designs the database scheme by applying the rules or conditions given by the blueprint or given by the database administrator, that is according to the blueprint. That is a database designer who designs. And the next person or the next user is your application programmer. Application programmer. So in an organization, the user will interact with the database through an application software. So these application softwares is designed by the application programmers. So what does the application programmer do? They design the application software. They design the application software and the user interacts with the database. User interacts with the database through this software. Okay, and next the important part is the or the person who uses the end user. So who is this end user? This is the person who uses the database for his purpose according to his requirements. This person will have the access to the database. So there are four types of users: database administrator, the person who is going to create, alter and use the database, and he is the one who gives the blueprint of the database. This is how it should be, this is how the table should look, this is the way the relation should work. Everything is given by the database administrator, and according to this blueprint, the database designer will design the scheme, and then the programs for this or the software is written by the application software, by the application programmer, and the end person is the one who is going to use this software. This is about the types of users that use the database. We'll continue in the next session.